This was Butiaba Health Center 3 in Bulisa District. Before it was submerged by floods, the facilities served between 1,000 to 1,400 patients every month. Since October 2020, when the disaster hit, the facility has been relocated thrice. First to Butiaba Primary School, then to Butiaba Sub-County Headquarters, and now it is temporarily housed at the Fisheries Resource Center.
The education system had closed, so we went to a primary school. We stayed there for something like 6 months before the reopening of the school. So when they announced that, a week before announcing, we received a letter from CAU's office and DEO that we were no longer to stay there because the facility could not operate with a school.
Regardless of being relocated thrice, the health facility is still in an appalling state. Faced with acute drug shortage, inadequate human resource, lack of electricity, the facility cannot ably serve the overwhelming numbers of patients.
We are serving a population of over, I would think, of 10,000, I think. But according to OPD attendees, we normally see around 80 to 100 patients a day, excluding MCH. Patients, those for YCC.
Power, we've been actually using solar, which has been on and off with issues. And then for drug stockout, we cannot really deny that, because in reality, due to the population which is coming at the lake currently, including Congolese who are coming to access the services at the facility, they are actually not in the budget. So we expect people we expect the facility to run out of stock of drugs.
Recently, the Prime Minister's office donated a tent to act as an admission ward in addition to other medical supplies. However, this did not deter the locals from shunning the facility. Many have resorted to herbal remedies.
Tera kunoga bisiko nenga mula kubisiko nenyo kubisiko kuba erije batuza naye tutiyayo abasirikale babera batu halasinga.
The flood infested area has also witnessed an increase in waterborne diseases such as bilharzia, typhoid and malaria, as officials explain.
Typhoid, bilharzia, then there's also an increase on malaria cases because of the flooding areas. Only that we are chanced that we did not actually get cholera as we would expect, were expecting, because this flood actually merged all the latrines.
The water is being shared with by the people, with the animals, and on top of that, we are having a problem of whichever bilharzia. in that matter, I think. I think the government should run out for this matter, and maybe it has to protect us.
In addition to support received from the office of the Prime Minister and other government agencies, the area has been greatly supported by civil society organizations such as Ford Foundation and Action Aid Uganda.
At least there were very many items which were donated to the communities through Action Aid, and then they also gave sponsored the community engagement meetings.
They have been of help because they were advising us from the time when we started receiving those floods in April, around 20th. They are giving us their knowledge, their skill, what they could do. They could mobilize the community on the way forward, tentative anyway, temporarily. And they also helped us in relocating.
The health facility was in October 2020 submerged by floods that resulted from the rising water levels of Lake Albert. The floods submerged staff quarters, maternity, male and female wards, stores and the outpatient department, among other facilities around the health center. 800 million shillings was allocated to construct a new health center. The project is currently underway by the UPDF Construction Brigade. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.